I know it's hard. You're going to have to go back to school. Yeah, everyone watching this video, you're going to have to go back to school. But at least if you're going to go back to school, you're going to have a nice Notion template to go along with it. So the way I like making this setup is going to be utilizing something I like to call the Earth tactic, where you use all the databases in the back end and then bring everything to a bunch of different views in the front. / synced block here, which I'm just going to put some text in to make it easy to navigate. Put some text, put a synced navigation bar here, /sync. And then within this, we're going to have to nestle another block right here under it. Then put a /h2 title, whatever you want to call it. This is essentially where we're going to have a lot of the main information on this page. Then below this, we're going to put a /list view. And we're not going to create a new database. We're going to leave this to select from a source in a second. We're just kind of making the framework of this. And then within this, if we can put an H3, it'd be more obvious. So we're gonna call this views, and then we're gonna put another H3. We're gonna call this databases. We're gonna make a /page, which is gonna be the earth or the backend or whatever will help you understand that it is all your databases in the backend. So then what we're gonna do is gonna make a /database full page, and we're gonna use this as a way to pull views in to this main home dashboard or school dashboard. So this one's gonna be the task database. What I like to do is make a list view that has a few different properties. You're gonna make a date property. You can then make a class property that is gonna be either a select or a multi-select. And then I'm gonna put some example ones in here just for the rest of this: math, English, science. And then you're gonna make a status property by using a checkbox, and then we're gonna put a relation. We're gonna put a notes one here for later, which is gonna require me to make a new database. Just give me a moment. So math assignments, I'm gonna call another one an English assignments, and I'm gonna change the dates within here to today. So then in order to take this somewhere, we're gonna copy this link to view, go back to our school home. I'm gonna click on this. Then we're gonna go to this task database, which is in the earth over here. We're gonna pull from that list view. And if we want to edit it, so we're gonna show the class, we're gonna show the date. And what we can do really quickly is make two different views that are convenient. So this one is gonna be called this week. And what we're going to have to do is add a few more properties here. So we're gonna make two different formulas. We're gonna call this day of the week. We're gonna make this called this week question mark, then make the new formula. So to do the day of the week formula, all you gotta do is do format date and then the name of your date property, parentheses property date, and then put a comma and then DDDD in end around quotes. And then for the this week one, starting with the parentheses, format date property, name of your date property, with the parentheses around it, and then putting a week, and then you're doing an if then boolean for whether the now time is this week or not. Just follow along with me and make this formula. Let me do a question mark here, this week, and if not, then not this week. So this is this week because it is June 16th. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna then filter by this week question mark and have this be is this week and save for everybody. And then we can duplicate this and then call this today and then filter this to where, instead of having that filter, you can just filter it where date is and the advanced ones today, save for everyone. And then we can call this section assignments. If we want to go back and change this name to assignment database, or just assignments, whatever your preference is. But then what we're going to do is duplicate this database in the back end and make a notes database. So we can do notes here. And then in order to make this one different, we're going to get rid of this status here. I'm going to take this, edit the name here to assignments, and then edit the property to be a relation and pull from the assignments section. Add the relation here. Then we're going to add another one called created time so that we know when this was made. And then we can do another one, which would be a property that is like a last edited time. So we'd have more of an understanding of things from that perspective. And if you want to make it easy for yourself to see the different databases, you're going to put a couple blocks here, then copy these and link to page or mention the page is fine. Then you'd be able to click into the databases at any point to see it. And then in the assignments, we're gonna need to do the inverse and make that notes relation. Edit the property, go take this notes property and make it a relation to the notes. So that anytime you'd have an example, English note that you'd take, you'd be able to go into it really quickly and see it on the other end of it. Now, what I would recommend you do here is actually make a very similar view to what you did with these assignments to your notes. So if I drop something here, put a space, then put a divider, then move this guy back up, and then do /link view of database, I can pull it from the notes, I can pull it from this list view, then all you're going to need to do is rename this to the two different names. So we're going to make it today view, and then you have the option to either filter it where it's like the created time is today, or the date is today, or the last edited, it's whatever is up to you. Then if we do another view with notes, pull that today view, but then edit it to this week, you do the same situation. So you can change this week formula or this day of the week formula to, say we do created time, which would make more sense for when you took notes, like what class date it was on. Then you could do the same thing here to change this to created time. And that would tell you what was made this week and what wasn't. And you can showcase the created time for both of these. And then what I would recommend you do is that you actually make an H2 that's a toggle, call this one notes, drop this one in here, and do the exact same thing for this assignments one. So that anytime you don't wanna have this showing, you just wanna look at notes or assignments, you can easily go in here. And then what we can do is we can copy the link to this page, paste it in here, link it to the page. So we call this school home or just home. Then what we would do is we would go back out one step from wherever this page is. So I'd go out here, duplicate this, put it in here, go in here, then you'd want to move this here and then rename it to your different subjects. So we can do math and redo the emojis and the aesthetics, and then go through the filter for all of these and add a rule in an advanced filter where you put an and after everything. Class is or contains the class that you are looking for. You can go through all of these. And if I want to ever hide any of these databases, you can do this. And if you ever want to bring it back, all you got to do is go here to this list or whatever view it is, and then you can toggle this on and off over there. And then what I would recommend you do is you duplicate this view and then quickly change it to the rest of the different classes. Call this one English and then science. And then now what you have is an assignment and note system that can easily be moved back and forth between all of your different subjects. And if you ever want to add any more views, all you get to do is do something like add from your notes database a calendar view, and you can change the calendar by in the source over here to created time so that you know like when the different task was created. Add the different class here, and you can do the exact same thing in any of these views as well, or you can go and pull from assignments, make a new view, show the class, the date, when the assignments are, and even add other things below if you are interested in making something like a bookmark section under here. And you could also do something like this to improve your overall productivity, or Notion, right here.